Good morning. Hallelujah. This is first Sunday of the month of July, and as we have gathered together in our homes to worship the Lord, the context what we are living in, we know that we are not able to come to the church, we are not able to meet with each other, but thank God for the technology. Thank God for the media that God has given us this blessing, that even through this we are able to reach in your houses, and we are able to have fellowship with one another, we are able to worship together, we are able to hear the word of God together, and what a joy it is. We as pastoral team, we look forward for this day as we used to meet with you all together. It was such a joyful time, but still we are meeting you in this way, and we believe that you all are ready to worship the Lord, worshiping the Lord in spirit and in the truth. And not only that much, let us have the desire that, Lord, speak to me through the word what will be spoken to us today. Lord, help me to worship you with all my heart, O God, as I am going to sing the songs, as I am going to worship the Lord with the online service. Lord, I pray that you will bless us this morning, O God. Shall we look into prayer? And not only just yourself, make sure that you and your family members, all of you, are worshiping together. This is the important day, dear friends. It is a privilege that we come into the presence of the Lord. Shall we just pray together as we bow down our heads and pray? Let's come together in God's presence. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We praise you and worship you, O God. Lord, we want to worship you, that who you are, O God. You are the creator of whole heavens and the earth, O God. You are the creator of whole humanity, O God. You are the creator of entire things in this world, O God. And Lord, here as your children, O God, as you said that whoever believes in you, O God, you give them the rights to become your children. And here your children, O God, your sons and daughters, O God, we come in your presence and we want to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, that you have given us this privilege that we can speak to you, we can worship you, we can sing unto you, and we know that you will accept it, O God. What a heart of our Heavenly Father. When we sing unto him, He is pleased with our worship. And Lord, I commit entire worship time, message time in your hand. Especially, Lord, I pray for our worship leader, Hazel, and the team as they are going to lead the worship. I pray that your presence will be felt, O God, and we will be ministered. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Over to Hazel. Please come.
Praise God. I hope you are doing fine. Even if it's not, hold on. In the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 28, it says, we know that God is always at work for the good of everyone who loves him. We know that God is always at work for the good of everyone who loves him. So, church, let's keep praising to the Lord. Let's keep trusting him. And here it says, God is always good for those who love him. This time, let's surrender ourselves wherever we are. Let's just close our eyes and say, Lord, yes, Jesus, we will be praising you. We will be loving you. We will obey you, O Lord Jesus. We will be trusting in your word, O Lord. Because, Father, Lord, your Bible, your word, it clearly says, those who love you, those who obey you, O Master, you are going to do something very great, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Father, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, today we come before you, Jesus. Father, we want to thank you, Father, for everything that you're doing to us in our lives, O Master. Jesus, thank you, Lord. Father, this life belongs to you, O Master, for you have created us and you have chosen us, O Lord. Father, my hope, my strength, all, it's all from you, O Jesus. Church, as we sing this first song, my life is in you, Lord. My hope, my strength, my everything is in you. Let's bring praises to our God by singing this song. Yes, Jesus. Father, our hope and strength, everything of us, bring praises to you, O Lord Jesus. Jesus. Our life is in your hands, O Lord Master. Lord, thank you, Jesus. Lord, you are our hope, O Lord. You are my strength, O Lord Jesus. Father, thank you, Jesus. Lord, thank you for this new month, O Lord. Lord, we surrender, O Lord Master. Lord, thank you, Jesus. Half of the year has almost gone, O Lord Master. Lord, you have been faithful, O Lord Jesus. Yes, Master, you are the same yesterday, today, and forever, O Lord Master. Lord, thank you, Father. Father, our hope, O Lord Master, it's you, O Lord Jesus. Lord, today you are strengthening us, O Master. No matter what situations we are going through, O Lord, Father, you have been guiding us, O Lord. We adore you, we love you, Master. We will exalt your name, O Lord Master, because you alone deserve it, O Lord Jesus. O Riba Baba Balandara Baradarandaria Karabaraba. O Rikarabara Karandaria Karaba. We will exalt your name, O Lord Jesus. Lord, this life belongs to you, O Lord Master. Let everything of us praise your name, O Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You are a Father. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Your majesty, I can put down. I lay my all before you now. In royal awe, I don't deserve. I will lift your majesty.
You are high and lifted up. Majesty, Lord, we bow before you, O Lord. We serve you, Jesus. We lay our everything, O Lord, Master. This life we lay down to you, O Lord, because, Father, you have been leading us, Lord. You are our majesty. You are our King, O Lord Jesus. We will keep serving you. We will keep praising you, O Master, because you are higher and lifted up, O Lord Master. Yes, Jesus. There can be nobody like you, O Lord.
I can be one. I lay my all before you now. In royal robes,
I don't deserve anything, O Father. But all that I can do is serve you, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Your majesty. You are higher and higher lifted up, Lord. Father, we deserve nothing, but Father, everything of us should bring praises to your name, O Lord Master. Oh, hallelujah. We will serve you, Lord. We serve you, O Majesty. You are our King, O Lord. Yes, Jesus. You are higher and lifted up. You alone are deserve for our praises, O Lord Master. Yes, Master, there is nobody like you, O Lord. Lord, in every situation, O Master, you are holding our hands, O Lord Master. Even in this pandemic time, O Lord, even when everything is happening wrong, O Lord Jesus, Father, we are safely in your hands, O Master. Lord, this is why we worship you today, O Lord. Yes, Jesus, with all of us, O Master, we worship you, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for your purpose in our lives, O Master. Heavenly Father, thank you for this time, Lord. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for your presence, O Master. Lord, thank you, Jesus, that you have reminded us, Lord, today, Lord, those who really love, those who really obey and keep trusting in you, O Lord, Master. Lord, you are working in their lives, O Lord. Lord, as Romans 8:28, it says, Jesus, Father, you are doing good of those who love you, Master. Lord, we will forever, we will praise you, O Lord. Keep trusting in your name, O Lord Jesus. Lord, thank you, Father. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for this day. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for your presence, O Lord, Master. Lord, committing further sessions into your hands, O Lord. Committing this worship into your hands, O Lord. In Jesus' name I pray and believe. Amen.
We know that our God is mighty God. We know that our Lord is sovereign Lord. And we know that our Lord is in control. Thank you, worship leader, especially Hazel and Sachin, Jacinta and Susma and Joel. All together, as you helped us in worshiping the Lord, now we will take time to pray for some important things which will be happening through the church. And especially we want to inform you that in this time of Corona season, we see that lot of prayers are going on through different people group, through the different people, different churches, and all of the world, all over the world we see that, especially we see our people group, the Christians, they are praying day and night, finding the ways in whatever way we can pray for our land, we pray for our people, we pray for our country, we pray for the entire world. And here, we also as a church, we want to be part of this. And so we thought like we will be having the 21 days prayer. And in this 21 days prayer, we request you, dear church, we request you, dear family of our church members, not only the old people, not only the mother and father, but entire family. Why don't we take time that every day 7 to 8 p.m. that is in the evening. We know that from 8 o'clock curfew will be there at night. And so 7 to 8, we are going to have 21 days prayer from 5th of July to 25th of July. And we know that everybody throughout the year, in the past years, as we used to have the prayer for 21 days, many of you used to come early morning 6 to 7, then afternoon 12 to 3, then evening 7 to 8. So we had been doing that, but we are not doing this time in the basement or in the prayer hall because we know we cannot gather. So what we will do, it's a better opportunity, best opportunity, that just gather at home, all family members sit together, and on the Zoom online, we will be praying 7 to 8 for different prayer needs we will be praying. So are you excited? Look forward and don't miss that 21 days. Just make it sure that, Lord, I want to be in this fellowship, and I want to be a prayer warrior. I want to pray and I want to see that, Lord, how you are going to handle the things. And we want to glorify God. So this is one thing. Another good news is there. And that is, if I tell you to guess, I don't know you will be able to guess or not. But this good news is about, since many months and years, it was going on in pastor's mind that we should have a Hindi service. But I don't know why it had not started, or right time has come now that it is going to start. And that service is going to launch from coming Sunday, should I say? No, it's not coming Sunday. It is from today only, today evening. So morning we have Kannada service, morning we have English service, and evening we will be having English to Hindi service. And that service is totally those who are originally Hindi speaking people. Now opportunity has come for you that you can hear God's word in Hindi language. So 7 to 8 again, every Sunday evening time 7 to 8 will be the Hindi service with English. English to Hindi service, and so look forward for that. Shall we pray for these two prayer needs, 21 days prayer and then English to Hindi service? Again, I ask in your family, if anybody is needing any prayer, especially this corona fear is everywhere. and it is good to be afraid of these things so that we will commit our lives to God and we will count it that Lord, each day what you give us, it is a gift from you. Anyone can get anywhere because of their carelessness. So Lord, give us wisdom that we will be alive, we will be living for you and by your grace, O God. Shall we pray? Let's close our eyes. If you are afraid for anything, if your heart is fearful, whatever reason it can be, fear of life, fear of job, fear of family, or anything which is really making you afraid, fear of death, fear of infection, fear of this viral infection, fear of this disease which is going on around, or fear of the things or the challenges what you have in your life. Wherever you are, in your house, I know. You are worshipping with your family member, I know. But can you just lift up your hands and say that, Lord, I feel weak, O God. I feel afraid, O God. When I go out from home to workplace or marketplace or whatever work I have, when I go out, I feel afraid, O God. I'm afraid of accident, O God. I'm afraid of death, O God. I'm afraid of my low immunity, O God. I'm afraid of my lonely life, O God. If you are feeling like that, why don't you lift up your hand? God is watching over. Jesus is living God. Jesus is loving God. And he is watching over. Scripture says that when we are weak, he is strong. Hallelujah. Sandaraba kashida raba andriya raba la kashida raba. Ribandriya raba baba baba kashida raba nidiya raba la kashida raba. The fearful hearts, O God, needs your favor, Lord. Needs your mercy, O God. Needs your grace, O God. Needs your strength, O God. And Lord, as hands are lifted towards you, O God, why not children? Why not senior citizen? Why not family members? Why not the people, those who help us in our house, O God? Every individual is important in your eyes, O God. And Lord, we want to thank you that you have seen their hands, O God, and you are strengthening them. You are blessing them with long life, O God. Lord, I pray for these 21 days of prayer time, Lord. Lord, we know that your heart is pleased when your children come to you, praying to you, O God, speaking to you, O God, spending time with you, O God. And when we come to you, as you put your hedge around us, Lord, that no power of darkness can touch us, O God. No power of Satan can touch any one of us, O God, because we are your children, O God. Thank you, Lord, that this opportunity you are giving to us, that we will be able to pray 21 days, O God. Enable us, O God, and help us to give priority to this, O God. Lord, I pray for even the Hindi service which is starting, O God. Lord, I pray that you will bless this service, Lord. Bless the pastor, O God. Bless his vision, O God. And especially the heart language for the Hindi speaking, your children, O God. Those who speak in Hindi, Lord, that you will minister to them, O God. Maybe it is South India, but many of them are here, O God, from North. And the Hindi language is there for them and they may not be able to understand South Indian languages, Lord. You will bless them with their heart language, O God, and you will speak to them, Lord. Thank you, Father, that you are hearing our prayers, O God. The good work what you are beginning through the church, Lord, we know that you will achieve what you have in your mind, O God. Committing all this time in your hand, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Dear church, remember that today is first Sunday and next Sunday is second Sunday. All of us, we know that second Sunday when we were gathering in the church, we used to have the communion together. And so, if you are at home, don't miss this. Yes, having communion at home, it is biblical. In the Bible, in the early church, we see in the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter 2, it talks about that they used to break the bread in their homes and have fellowship. So, we facilitate that as through the church we do that communion cups and the bread, all these things are in package. You will be getting that. Come to the office hours, you can collect, or let us know, we will just see to it that you have got it. And that is what will be the communion. So next Sunday prepare ourselves that we will be part of communion. And every month, as we have couples fellowship, especially the wife and husband together, we used to meet together and we had good fun time, game time. But look forward, coming Wednesday on 8th July, we are having 7 to 8 p.m. we will be having couples fellowship with lot of activities and learning, especially from the Word of God. Look forward, do not miss it. Wherever you are, you can be online, and that is through the Zoom couples fellowship. So let's look forward, and we will be there together. Yeah, thank you. Okay, this is the time now that we will go for the offering. Offering box is not going to come to your home. And many of you have been asking that we are collecting the offering, how to reach it to the church. Daytime it is open time, working hours and all, if you find time you can always reach it. And you know that this is the time of crisis also, that many people are needing help. Whatever offering you put, whatever tithes you put, whatever your faith pledge is there, everything is going for the extension of God's kingdom. And that's why we encourage you, the tithes giver, the faith pledge or the offering, do not just hesitate. Do not just read the word, do not just sing the song, do not just worship the Lord, but giving is also an act of worship. And I know that our church, they know it. Giving is an act of worship. Give cheerfully. God sees our heart and God sees our hand, and God will bless you. So far, God has not lacked anything, those who believe in Him. And even word says that the righteous ones will never stretch forth their hands. So nobody is going to beg you. But the thing is, Bible says we should give cheerfully for the extension of God's kingdom. We encourage you, don't go out now. Just continue to worship the Lord, hear the word of God throughout the day. Time is there. You have the Google Pay, you have the phone pay, you have the bank transaction IDs are there. If you are interested, let me not tell you. I am your pastor and I want to tell you, continue to do good things what you have been doing, and God will bless you. Shall we pray for the offering? Loving Heavenly Father, O God, what a joy it is that we are all your children, O God. There is no caste, there is no creed, there is no rich, there is no poor in your kingdom, O God. Early church saw to it that nobody lacks anything, O God. They used to sell their things, O God. They used to bear their burdens, O God. And Lord, even as you have made us your children, with your blood, O God, you made us your blood-related children, O God. And Lord, we want to thank you. Thank you for this opportunity that we are able to give something what we have, O God. And Lord, bless every believers, those who obey your word. Those who obey your word, O God. You love the obedient hearts, O God. You love the obedient homes and families, O God. And Lord, I pronounce blessing upon them that they will be blessed, O God. Thank you, Jesus, that you have given us this privilege. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
तेरे नाम के लिए जिए हम, तेरे नाम के लिए जिए हम, यीशु नाम के लिए जिए हम, तेरे नाम के लिए जिए हम. तू बड़े, मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन से महिमा तुझे मिले. तू बड़े, मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन से महिमा तुझे मिले. स्तुतियों के बीच में विराजमान प्रभु, तू बड़े और मैं घटूं। स्तुतियों के बीच में विराजमान प्रभु, तू बड़े और मैं घटूं। तू बड़े मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन से महिमा तुझे मिले। तू बड़े मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन मिले।
यीशु नाम में है चंगाई, यीशु नाम में है रिहाई, यीशु नाम में है यीशु नाम में है सच्चाई, यीशु नाम में है चंगाई, यीशु नाम में है रिहाई, यीशु नाम में है भलाई, यीशु नाम में है सच्चाई। तू बड़े मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन से महिमा तुझे मिले। तू बड़े मैं घटूं, मेरे जीवन महिमा तुझे मिले।
It's a time to hear the word of God, first Sunday of the month, and as we prepare ourselves to hear the word of God, now I will call upon Pastor Dr. Daniel Koti, prayerfully as he has prepared. For sure there is something God has stored for you. Listen attentively, do not get disturbed. And now I call upon Pastor Dr. Daniel Koti to share the word of God. Over to him. Thank you.
Good morning. It's a great day. A new month has begun, and it's a privilege for us to worship God. I trust you have had a good time thinking about and expressing gratitude to God for all the great things that He has done in this new month. I would like to tell you that this day, late in the evening from 7 onwards, we're going to start 21 days of prayer on Zoom. And that link will be sent to you. Please join us every day from 5th to 25th of this month. And 1 hour of prayer time, where we will be spending time to pray for you, pray for the needs of the world, as well as any special prayer concerns that you have. So I invite you to please join. The second thing that I want you to pay attention is about the Hindi service kind of a thing that we're going to start again from this day, this evening. We will send you the time and the link. I would invite you to recommend it to those people who will not be able to understand Kannada or even English. That's especially focused for the Hindi speaking friends. So that's our special new things, because new month has come. We are doing some new things. And on Wednesday 7th, there will be the couples fellowship as usual, but then which will be focused on family and prayer. So I would invite you to please join. Also, those who are couples, please join for that also in a very special way That's a personal invitation to you. Okay? So at this moment, we're going to start a new series this month. Again, in reflecting upon the context in which we are living, the tough context and the times in which we are living, trying to help us to journey through to understand these tough times. So, a new series again. And so before we launch into that, I would like to give you the kind of title for that. It is How to Face Difficult Times. Okay, that's the title of this series. How to Face Difficult Times. And step by step, one step at a time, week after week, we will take one step and study it and then go to the next step. So, how to face difficult times. That's the theme and the thought in this new month that we are going to be studying and meditating. So, shall we at this moment begin with the word of prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful morning and the privilege that you have given to us to worship you together. And we want to thank you for this opportunity that you are giving to us to study and meditate upon your word. I pray as we study and meditate your word, speak to us. Speak to us, O God. Holy Spirit, take charge of this time and minister to us, O God. We surrender ourselves to you. We commit ourselves to you. We come against all plans of the enemy to disturb and distract. I pray that our focus will be upon your word and that you will speak to us, Lord. We commit ourselves, surrender ourselves to you and pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. So, this important study that we want to start, as I said, the how to face difficult times. Many people in these days did not expect this sudden change of situation. We had all different plans to go here, to go there, to have this vacation, to have this program. This we had all the annual plans in a way, but then everything went haywire, you know, all went topsy-turvy. And you know why? Because of the lockdown due to the coronavirus, everything changed. And many who were thinking that life is kind of like this only, many of us had life like as if it was fun and joke, always enjoying, you know. Suddenly a reality hit that no, this world is different. This world is different. Hard times. Education is not taking place. Jobs are going. Financial problems have increased. Now, how do we face this world in this kind of a situation? Some people are facing some of their own troubles, especially during difficult times. Different people are behaving in a different way. A man was being taken to COVID hospital from his house, and as he was being taken, he told his wife, If something goes wrong, which means if I may not come back, okay? If something goes wrong, just remember there are some special precious gifts in the cupboard and they all belong to you. He told his wife. And his wife heard it and she responded, if something goes wrong, if you will not make it, everything in your cupboard belongs to me, you know. And that's the reality. You know, suddenly in difficult times, difficult situations are emerging in the homes and families also. Now, I want to help us understand how to face this difficult times through a context of a church. It's called the Church of Thessalonica. We would request you, I'll request you to please turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verses 17 to chapter 3 verse 5. That will be our focus passage. But I want you to notice some very, very interesting things. Paul, the founder of this church, is longing to see Thessalonians. Paul knew that Thessalonian church was going through difficult time. So he is writing to them. This is what he says, "But brothers and sisters, we were orphaned by being separated from you for a short time, in person, not in thought. Out of our intense longing, we made every effort to see you." Paul was longing to see and meet the Thessalonian church. Paul was, you know, in emotional pain, in grief and in loneliness for being separated from these people. Paul had started this church in Thessalonica. Paul had lived with these people. Paul had worked with these people, but he is now separated. Something like us today. It's been months now. We have not seen your face, some of you. But in verse 18, 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 18, Paul says, "For we wanted to come to you. Certainly I, Paul, did again and again. But Satan blocked our way." Satan blocked our way. You know that blocked our way. Paul is mentioning that Satan blocked the way, which would mean blocked the way means broke up the road, put up an obstacle. Or originally what he meant was like when it was a military practice, when you are being chased by your enemy, what they used to do is cut up the road, dig up the road so that the pursuing army cannot cross and come after you. Like that. So Satan had put an obstacle. Paul was convinced satanic activity stopped him from getting to Thessalonica. We also want to meet, but we cannot. Problem is of the virus. Due to this, all this lockdown has come. We are not able to meet because of this virus problem. But Paul was not able to meet the Thessalonica church because Satan had blocked the way. And as we jump further to third chapter of 1 Thessalonica, and we read from verse 2 and 3. "We sent Timothy, who is our brother and co-worker in God's service in spreading the gospel of Christ, to strengthen and encourage you in faith so that no one would be unsettled by these trials, for you know quite well that we are destined for them." You know, this is interesting for us. Please notice this. Difficult situations can cause some casualties, some flops, some failures among believers. Because notice in verse 2, what it says is that to strengthen, we are sending Timothy to strengthen and encourage you in faith. Why? Why there is a need of strength? Because of the difficulties and hardships that you are facing, you have become weak. So you need to be strengthened. And why he is sending them, Timothy, to encourage? Because difficulties has discouraged you. Difficulties has discouraged you. Difficulties and trials has weakened your faith. So you need to be strengthened. You need to be encouraged. And then in verse 3 we see, so that no one would be unsettled. That word unsettled is to from the original Greek, this is what it means, to shake your tail back and forth like a dog wagging its tail. You know, to shake, to shake you back and forth as a dog wags its tail. When people face difficulties, when you and I go through difficulties, this is the problem. We can become weak and we can become discouraged. And not only that, we can also be unsettled, or we can be wavering like a dog's tail. Some people become like dog also, you know, not only wagging the tail, but also become like dog. Paul knew trials can make you feel like you're being shaken and you are being pushed from pillar to post kind of a situation. Job is gone. Nobody is accepting new employment. Education is stopped. What to do? How do I face my future? In the fifth verse, 1 Thessalonica chapter 3 verse 5, Paul says, "For this reason, when I could stand it no longer, I sent to find out about your faith. I was afraid that in some way the tempter had tempted you and that our labor might have been in vain." What is Paul fearing? Trials or troubles or difficulties can lead a believer into a temptation. During difficult times, we can fall into temptation. That's the danger. See, when we are weak, when we are discouraged, when we are feeling unsettled, we can fall in sin and commit disobedient acts. Disobedient acts. So that's what Paul is worried about. But then let me make a clarification here. What are these difficult times? What are these trials? Okay. How are they special? See, trials are not temptations to commit sin or disobey God. Okay. Trials is an external circumstances, hardships. No, it's an external circumstances in our lives that causes trouble or causes to be under a burden, or even causes anxiety. That's what, it's an external circumstances. Like, we feel like an animal trapped in a zoo kind of a thing. You cannot come out free. You are not able to be, you're feeling trapped. That, like the way we are experiencing due to coronavirus. All freedom is gone. Oh, the way we used to live, everything has changed. So, that's the difference. Temptation is to commit sin, but trials or hardships is the circumstances in which we live. Okay, so that's a very interesting, distinction, difference between trials and temptations. Okay, now how do we face and deal with such difficult times? There are different steps, but today I'm going to deal with only one thing. One thing, but through this series we will pay attention to all the ways in which we can deal with difficult times. Okay, but number one, the first step, the first important understanding that we need to have about our difficulties is we need to accept these difficult times, we need to recognize that this is something that is appointed, and this is not by an accident. This is by an appointment and not by an accident. Because notice, in verse 3, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 3 and verse 3, notice what Paul says there. "So that no one would be unsettled by these trials, for you know quite well that we are destined for them." We are destined for them. The other word is appointed for that. You have been appointed for that. Paul is telling to the believers in Thessalonica who are in difficulties that remember, this is what we were appointed for, hardships and difficulties. Now, our appointment, it's like a job appointment. When you get a job, you go and what do? Go and sleep there? No. You have an appointment, means you have to go and do the job. Likewise, that's what Paul is telling. These difficulties are like appointments that you need to meet. Like if you go to the hospital, medical appointment, like that. You need to go and go through that. So difficulties also, hardships also in life come as appointments. Appointments. God has either actively decided or passively decided to allow these things to happen. God has decided these things. Okay. But here, let's remember these things, these hardships. When God created this world, in fact, there was no difficulty for mankind at all. But once man fell into sin, there is difficulty everywhere, hardships everywhere, struggles everywhere. And Jesus Christ came to help us understand and face these difficulties, because we are heading towards a direction where there will be no hardships, there will be no tears. That's where we are heading. So, you and I are appointed to face this kind of difficulties like a gemstone. When it is discovered, it needs to go through a rough polishing. If it does not go through a rough polishing, it will not be a gem. It's like a tea bag. If it is not put into the hot water, it will never release the taste of the tea. Likewise, you and I are appointed to go through these difficult times, because that's when the polishing takes place. To some people, it can discourage. To some people, difficulties can cause weakness. To some people, difficulties can cause you to be unsettled, baseless, rootless. But if you accept it, recognize this is something that I am appointed for, your perspective will change. Because there are lots of wrong understandings about difficult times, difficulties, hardships. Some people think that trials or this hardships or difficulties are a sign of sin or disobedience. Or this hardships and difficulties are punishment for your sin. Punishment for your sin or disobedience. That's a wrong way to think. Not necessarily. It may not be. The difficulties in which you and I are not necessarily a direct result of your sin or anybody's sin or anybody's disobedience. It may not be. What makes me say that? Turn with me to Matthew chapter 5, verse 45 onwards. In verse 44, Jesus tells, this is in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus speaks about why that we should love our enemies and pray for our enemies. He tells that, love your enemies and pray for your enemies. And then very next verse, 44, he tells that, and 45, this is what the Bible says. He, that is God, causes, especially I'm reading the latter part there, he, that is God, causes his son to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. That's God. And that's God whom you and I worship. And that's the God whom we obey. He sends sun on the righteous and the unrighteous people. He sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous people. Good people and bad people. Both of them, he gives them rain. He gives them sun. He gives them rain and he gives them sun. Yeah, we live in a sinful world. I agree. It's like living in a pressure cooker. We live in an imperfect world. Very true. Very true. But trials and difficult circumstances that we are in are not sign of sinfulness. It can lead us. Yes, sin can lead us to the consequences, because Bible says there is wages for sin. Okay, disobedient life gives you salary. Even if you are unemployed, you indulge in sin, there is salary for it. Okay, but trials are not direct result of sin. No. And please remember, trials and difficulties can also be because of righteous life. Living righteously, you live righteous life, because of that trials come, difficulties come. Have you noticed this? Jesus in Mark chapter 4 and verse 35 onwards, we read this beautiful story where Jesus tells his disciples, let's go to the other side of the lake. And all of them packed up and boarded the boat, and Jesus is resting. They go, and right in the middle of the night, middle of the sea, there is a storm. Hey, they were going in obedience to Jesus' command. They did not go out of their, oh, let's have a picnic today. No. They did not think, we are tired, let's take a break today. No. They went in obedience to Jesus' command. And in obedience, as they are walking further or sailing further, there is a storm waiting for them. Can you say that that storm was because of their sin and disobedience? No way. In fact, we read the whole book of Acts. The way believers went through trials and difficulties. Why? Is it because of the sin? No. It was because of their obedience to Jesus Christ. They went through trials and difficulties. So you cannot generalize and say, this difficulty is there today for us because of sin and disobedience. No. Difficulties can come, also can come for living a good, obedient and righteous life. If so, there is another misconception and misunderstanding that also we should clarify. That is, some people think this, okay? God's main goal for your life and my life is happiness, success, and a problem-free life. Really? Some of us are thinking that. Some of us are thinking that God's purpose for your life is happiness, success, and problem-free life. Wrong. You are totally wrong. Why? God's primary purpose for you and for me is that you and I will become like His Son, Jesus Christ. That's why we are called to go and make disciples, that we will be like our teacher. You and I don't make or become the disciples of disciples, we become disciples of Jesus Christ. That's what He has called us for. That's what He is asking us. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. And as we read, and we all who with unveiled faces contemplate the Lord's glory are being transformed into His image with ever increasing glory, which comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. That's what is happening. He is at work in our life, and His primary purpose for your life and my life is not that we become successful or that we become rich or we become prosperous or we have no problem. No, 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 no. His primary purpose for your life and my life is that we become like Jesus. Maybe second and third, maybe about happiness, about success, anything else you can add that. But the first and foremost purpose of what Jesus or what God wants to do in your life is that you will live like Christ, you will behave like Christ, you will work like Christ, Jesus, and you will demonstrate who Jesus is to the world. That's the primary purpose of your life, our life. So, we must recognize this. These are the dangerous misconceptions. One is linking sin and disobedience to bad times. Another thing of linking success and prosperity to be the primary purpose of being with or following Jesus. Okay, remember that word, verse 3, destined, which would mean that He knows your weaknesses. He knows your strengths. He knows your abilities. And knowing your ability, knowing your strength, knowing your skills, knowing your tolerance capacity, He destined destined. It's your destination. You are in the destination, in this journey. You are heading in the right direction. And in that direction, He ensured that this kind of a hardship and difficulty will come tailor-made for you, tailor-made for me. Like a tailor who prepares a cloth, like a shirt, God has planned these circumstances for you and for me. Not for the previous generation, not for the future generation, but for your generation and my generation. This situation was planned, appointed by God for you and for me. This is not a surprise thing for God. The hardships that we are facing, the difficulties that we are facing, this situation has approval from God. We don't understand it, right? How? You know, the why we don't understand it is, it's about understanding the purpose of God. If you recognize that God's purpose for your life and my life is for us to be transformed into the image of His dear Son, if that is what we understand, then we will understand the difficulties that we go through, the hardships that we go through, the persecutions or pain and suffering that we go through. If we understand this, that the purpose of Jesus in my life is that I will become like Jesus, I will speak like Jesus, I will conduct like Jesus. Important word. Many times we fail to understand this purpose of God in our life. Purpose of God in our life. And especially when we are talking about this, the hardships and difficulties, Jesus told us that this is possible. In John chapter 16 verse 33, this is what the Bible says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. In this world you will have trouble. This was promised. This was told already. Jesus told that this is going to happen. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 4, the latter part of verse 4, this is what Paul says as he writes to Corinthian church, I am greatly encouraged in all our troubles. My joy knows no bounds. Can you think about it? Troubles are there, but because of these troubles, these trials, these difficulties, I am encouraged. Why? He knows that the gemstone is being polished. Like the diamond that is being polished. He knows that. And it's going to result in what? Joy. Joy. In all our troubles, my joy knows no bound. Peter also mentions this. In 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12 and 13, we read the same. You know, the importance of trouble. Dear friends, do not be surprised at the painful trial you are suffering, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice that you participate in the sufferings of Christ, so that you may be overjoyed when His glory is revealed. You know, there is an interesting link between the trials, the difficulties, the hardships, and joy. Especially as God's children, you and I must recognize the hardships that you and I are going through have a purpose of joy and happiness in our life. So, hardships have come. Trials have come. Difficult circumstances have come. What shall we do? Some people are going and hanging themselves. Some people are creating problem in the homes. Some people are becoming nuisance to the society. Some people are doing all crazy things. Confused in these hardships. What should I do? What should we do? Do you know what we should do? We should accept that hardships are appointed. Hardships are not by accident. Hardships are appointed. They're appointed. So it's like I'm going to my appointment. I'm going to that appointment. Are you ready to go to your appointment? Will you accept this as an appointment? These difficulties that you are seeing? If you accept it, you know what? That's what we will recognize, because these hardships, these trials will translate your in your life, to will work in your life, will cause in your life to result in joy. Because the purpose of my life is not wealth, power, position. My purpose of my life is to become like Jesus. And that's what the Bible talks of. Okay, so today we will start this new perspective, this new journey. So I want to invite you, and all through this month we are going to look at how to face hardships. And this is the first step of hardship, accepting or dealing with difficult times, is to accept them, to accept these difficult times as appointed times, not accidental times. Okay, accept them as appointed times, as those which were told in the job description. When you follow me, when you come with me, difficulties will come, hardships will come. In fact, hardships and difficulties are now everywhere. Everyone is facing. So in that, we as God's people must be willing to accept these as appointments, because these hardships will result in a time of joy. And that's where we are heading. Not a time of discouragement, not a time of being unsettled, not a time of weakness, but a time of joy. In that direction we are heading. Are you ready for that? So maybe at this time, shall we bow down our heads and commit our hardships, commit our trials, commit our difficulties, all these questions that are coming, why God, why this is happening, just hand it over. Let's just hand it over to God and say, Lord, I know this is what was appointed and I am going to face it. Okay, shall we bow down our heads in prayer? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for reminding us today through your word that, Lord, difficulties and hardships, trials are appointed for God's people. And because you have a purpose in our life, that we will be transformed into the image of your dear Son. I pray, Lord, in these difficult days, help us not to panic or get into wrong understanding that this is because of sin and get into a guilt trap. Or be confused that God's primary purpose is all about our success. No, help us to understand the primary purpose that you have for our life is that we be transformed into the image of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Everyone listening to your word today, every young person, every old person, may recognize, Lord, that difficulties are not by accident. Hardships are not by accident. These painful situations are not by accident. As God's people, they have come on appointment because God is at work in our lives. Give us that courage. Give us that boldness. Help us. None of us must be unsettled. None of us must go through discouragement. None of us must go through weakness, O God. But recognize this is God's divine appointment, and allow ourselves to be polished like a diamond, O God, and shine for you in the context in which you have placed. And thank you. Thank you very much. May this month be full of these kind of shining opportunities to shine for you. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' precious and mighty name we pray. Amen. Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, communion and fellowship of the Holy Spirit may rest and abide upon our lives now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you. Looking forward to seeing you again. God bless.
In his time, in his time, he makes all things beautiful. In his time, Lord, my life to you I bring. in His time, in Your time, in Your time, You make all things beautiful in Your. Lord, my life to You I bring. May each song I have to sing be to You.